Hi, I'm Albin Olofsson at Developer World at Sony Ericsson, and today I am in King's Langley, just outside London, to meet with Imagination Technologies. Imagination Technologies provides the graphics core for Satio, and today we're going to get some in-depth instructions on how to do really cool graphics for Satio. So now I am at Imagination Technologies, and I'm here with Gordon McLaughlin, who is a developer technology engineer. So Gordon, what do you do?
I work to support developers and internally to support development of 3D applications which take advantage of Power VR hardware.
Okay, so the reason why I'm here at Imagination Technologies is because your graphics core is in the Satio device. Tell us just a little bit about the graphics core.
Well, the graphics core is a portion of the chip designed to accelerate your 3D or 2D graphics rendering. In the Satio, there's a Power VR SGX, which is one of our latest cores, and that's a part of the OMAP 3 chipset from Texas Instruments.
So it's a little small mini graphics card.
That's exactly right.
So what can I, as a developer, do with that? How can I utilize it, and what can I get out of it?
Well, to use it, you need to choose one of the graphics APIs, such as OpenGL ES2, and then you would...
Which is in the Satio.
That's right. And then you'd write your program to take advantage of this API, provide it with models and data, and OpenGL ES2 is a programmable architecture, so you'd write shaders, which are little programs that run on the GPU, and... With this flexibility and customization from the programmable architecture, you can produce almost any graphics that you could imagine.
Okay, so if I am a 3D game developer, does a lot of 3D games, I can create a lot of different effects, and I can
That's right.
It quite easily.
Yeah.
But what if I am not into 3D graphics? I do apps that I do mobile apps like social applications, social networking apps, and or like Twitter apps and stuff like that. Is there anything that I can use in OpenGL ES2.0 that will pimp my app, that will make it stand out? And is that easy to do?
Well, another way to approach ES2 is as a kind of addition to your application. You can take a simple effect, which is based on not as much in the way of assets. So you're not trying to make a full virtual world here. And you can add it as a sprinkling of eye candy to your application and to enhance the user experience.
So what is the process? How do I do it? Well, I guess you're providing tools. How does the tool chain look like, and what do I do as a developer?
We provide you with tools for every step in this process in the form of applications, and these are cross-platform. We also provide you with a set of a library of functions for 3D, and we provide you with tutorials which go from a single getting a single triangle on the screen all the way through to complex shader effects and even a fairly complex and fully realized engine.
Okay.
All of the source code for this is provided, and it's all available free.
Okay. And I guess now you're going to show me a little bit of example on what what it actually looks like.
Okay, sure. This is PVR Shaman, our integrated shader editor. Here you can see a pod scene and animation which we've exported using our scene exporter tool PVR Geopod. In PVR Shaman, you can edit the materials applied to the meshes in your scene by assigning textures that can be optimized using PVR Text Tool. You can add shaders and edit them with the built-in editor, a little like this. As you can see, the sky's changed color in the scene now, and all this is done while the animation is still taking place. PVR Shaman allows you to generally examine and prototype elements of your 3D renderings before they ever need to be realized in code. So you can explore the scene freely, you can edit such things as light positions, and in the shader editor you can even get dynamic cycle counts for your shaders, which can allow you to begin optimizing these without having to render anything on your device. The next step in your development cycle would be to start prototyping your actual code in PVR VFrame, which is our PC emulation environment. So you can do this all within the realms of your desktop PC, and you don't actually have to put code onto the device at any stage. Obviously, once you've prototyped, you want to move on to running on the actual device, and in this case, you can start using our performance optimization tools to help you identify bottlenecks and problems with your application so you can get the frame rate up and allow these applications to be the best that they can be. And this is what it looks like on the Satio.
So So thank you, Gordon, for showing us the SDK and for having me here.
Thank you.
And to all you developers watching, I just want you to know that you can go to developer.sonerikson.com and there is a link to your SDK together with all the documentation you need. And you can also get support from Imagination Technologies if you would run into any problems. So now I think we will encourage you to go and do cool stuff for Satio. Thank you.
Thank you.